Anything to add, please?
Look at the right foot and the left foot when you do that.
Okay.
Watch her feet. Ouch. See where that foot stops? See where her right foot stopped?
Yes.
Okay, now watch for the other side. Keep going. Okay.
What am I looking for?
Well, what's the differences in the way you move her? What do you see?
I was thinking I was proportional, but I'm not, I guess.
It has nothing to do with proportions. If we're walking here, oops, okay. If I stop her here, her foot didn't slide as far. So if I stop early, see where the foot's stopping? You did that a bunch of times.
Okay.
Okay. And then on this one, you'd get her a little bit further back. That would stop it there. Then that foot, you'd float that foot.
Okay.
And the reason is, on this foot, you'd bring her down the line more, so that foot would float. On this foot, you'd pull her straight, and the foot wouldn't float. You'd stop it.
Okay.
But if I bring her down the line just a little bit, she cranks out. So now you find the balance in there at some point, and that foot should just, whew, just disappear.
So he was early?
If we're moving and I stop you short, see where your foot stopped?
Yes.
Okay.
So with the hands, this is just...
Oh, so there's another target window that I need to aim for, where both feet are in an airless
and
way.
And they just float out.
Wow.
When you hit your timing right.
Okay. Wow.
Nancy goes, huh? What?
As usual.
You're kidding me.
Are you popping your hands or curling the cookies in?
Popping a sheet.
Oh, that's a little different.
You're drawing a circle.
That's what I was thinking.
You're drawing a circle with your hand. Now, what's the center moving? How's the center moving? It's scooping. If I just move and I pull, see, that was a straight line. Or I can move. Now both feet popped out because I circled my hands.
Okay.
Flick. Flick the boogers off your fingers.
You know, this is...
And I'm not calling you a booger.
Thank you. Thank you.
No, you're just pulling straight towards you and up. Just boom. Keep your hands. Keep your hands in the same place. Just a little circle. Follow her center. Not up.
It's a practice.
Let's get slower.
Now, bring that foot back to your other foot.
Pull her to you. There you go. Now don't turn around and throw it, okay? As he makes this step, look at the line down his feet. If I drilled holes through his ankles and put a rod through there, that line would point there, okay? So as this foot crosses midline, how much does he weigh at midline right here? That's body rise, right? And then from there out, his body fall. Mm-hmm. But there's a line that goes straight down there. Remember that off balance?
Yep.
Okay. So now, as this foot comes forward, I go straight down this line. And he's going to wrap around me. And then I'm going to put my hip in.
Big difference.
No, it's done completely on the move. Just walk down that line, turn your hip just a little bit, booty bump him, he'll fall down.
No, that's not it.
Just walk straight through his arm. Step, step.
Step, step in.
Step, step.
At least the real thing about
I'm not gonna
rip some
ta-da, 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 ta-da. Da, 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 da. It is a waltz. Da, 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 da. Watch. If we're moving and I'm looking at this foot, I can float that foot. But I have to take his shoulder out and around just a little bit. So some of that happens right there. And if I want that foot to float, I turn that shoulder around. Okay? So it's just really subtle. But now when we're playing with both, that's what happens. Wham! Boom. 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 I kind of like the whoosh a little bit.
Come rope with us on. Come rope with us on. You're tensing up with them. They got to be able to see how they walk in the way.
Step, step. There you go.
That's it.
Now, you're taking this big a step.
Right.
Just go. Boop, boop. Don't step wider than your shoulders.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, just go. Boop.
Yeah,
booty bump.
Start simple. Almost as I'm in body drop, catch that curling of that wave right there. You see that crack?
Yep.
Great!
He's not stepping. Wait for him to step. You want to wait for this to get close to midline.
Are the hands moving at the same time?
No, you're following it.
On this, for both feet, yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
That was my problem.
But you can still move both hands at the same time and still get one foot to float a little bit more by going off just the side just a little bit. That's why I showed you do one hand, I can circle, mm-hmm. and that foot floats around, or the other side. But if I do one hand, I can still float that foot. But they don't pull with the same amount of force.
But they're moving at the same
time. They move the same time, but they're still moving independently with force.
Sometimes I don't want to give you a chance. No,
so he's running into you, so what's the issue?
I'm not letting him go behind me.
No. Are you early or late?
I am early.
You're early. And are you closing the distance too much or giving him room to complete the circle?
Okay. I'm probably closing.
Give him a little bit more space and see. Step, step. There you go. Boop. Now that was quite a bit of a lift. And also, he's not a normal walker because he's not a judo player. See?
It's Suke's fault.
It's all Suke's fault.
Just blame it on Suke.
So when you get this motion,
yeah.
See how short? It's just, yeah. Just boom.
Boom.
When this driver hits, booty bump. Okay. He'll fall down. Look at that.
I'm going to learn this throw. I'm going to make this happen. This is a throw I didn't think caught it, but I've never done this in Rondori. So that's why I'm learning.
That's good. That works for me.
Step, step.
It's too funny for me to see you get frustrated.
You're around.
Practice. Am I doing that type of movement forward, or should I just walk backward?
I'd walk normal. Ayumi Ashi.
He's been doing really generous Kinkei stuff.
Now, Nancy,
that was too much of a pull.
When you go to do your thing, stomp the floor.
Stomp the floor?
Stomp the floor.
That's it.
Don't pull my skull into your forehead, you.
I'm going to stomp the floor.
Just stomp the floor.
What? Where?
What is that doing?
What is that doing?
It's putting the energy that your foot, your body has to catch all this weight.
Uh-huh.
So as your muscles catch it all, that energy goes all the way through your body.
Okay.
So you're using that whole, you're all the muscles in your body for the pop. If you'll notice when I do this, I'm moving around, and when I go to pop the guy,
right,
I do it with my foot.
On her.
When we're moving. Did you hear the little footprint?
Yep.
Okay. Now, if I'm matching steps with you, which I always do, I know where your feet are. So now when I go to pop, your feet are in sync with mine, so you never feel me change step. You don't feel me
right.
Do that.
You just do that little.
And that energy generates right to your hands. But you got to have the timing first. John's going, huh?
What?
What
are y'all doing down there on the other end of the room? What is she learning? What is she learning down there?
She's learning that there's a plyometric response through your whole body when you stomp your foot.
Okay.
Okay, so they're doing advanced foot sweep drill, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just moving, catch, catch. But there's a way to float the foot.
Huh.
Okay, so that's the hand action. I'm just not stepping through and blasting you at the same time
okay.
with the foot sweep. So now what I'll do when I'm playing is we'll just be moving around and I'm going to pop the sheet, but I do it from that step. It's boom, and your feet just go whoosh.
Yeah.
You're holding his body back and his feet keep up.
Well, your center is moving backwards. As you're moving, taking that back step, I'm just popping you up off of it.
Is this the sort
of the other direction?
That kind of
boom. Yeah.
Okay.
You're gonna pop the towel.
Okay. Let's try.
Yeah. Boop. It's just that
pop
simple.
The towel.
And stomp.
Pop the towel and stomp.
Stomp.
I don't know if I can do both.
Stomp your supporting foot. Push your sweeping foot right through them.
Oh, yeah. Oh, can you imagine?
I got to do two things.
Can you imagine we haven't added the other part?
She's realizing that there's another part to
this. Oh, yeah. And it's beautiful.
Now, the easiest way to learn this is do one leg first. So as he's walking, this hand's going to control this foot. Let's move this way so we don't hit the wall back here. So you know that for him to walk, He has to bend his knee, pick his foot up, slide across the floor, put his foot down, right? Now, when his foot gets to midline, he's at body rise, so he's weightless. So now if I just take my hand and do just a little circle, at that point, that foot will float because his shoulder is going to end up over here and he can't put his foot down. So we just walk. And I walk him right out from under his foot. See? And if I want to do the other foot, I'm just going to do this off the elbow. But it's a little bit more difficult because we have some movement in here. Okay. So you just want to control that. It's just a little bit different timing. And then you get to where you can go boink, 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 boink. And you can walk people all over the place. And then you get to a point where you can just pop both feet. Because you know the timing. When that foot crosses midline, if I pop both feet out, that motion happens and your brain goes, oh crap. And then if I do that in that advanced foot sweep, so we're moving here. It's miraculous.
Now relax.
You didn't feel the circle, man. Draw a circle with your hand.
Okay.
Little circle.
Little circle.
When his foot, when this foot steps, it's just. Nice and slow.
It's not. All right, let's just go.
Now, if you stop your feet at the same time, it's not going to happen. I'll do this, and this foot's floating, because as soon as I pop you, I'm coming through with advanced foot sweep.
Okay. Pop me.
See, we're going to move down the line, and I'm going to push through on that pop.
Can I feel that?
Sure. Pretty powerful. And I didn't drop my center into you on that one. A big guy, boom, blow through you with my belly button.
It's best that you stay out at the arm.
Thank you.
And get your grip from out there. I know you're not used to playing out there, but.
No, it's hard for me. That's a lot of work keeping my arms way out there. Greg says I'm coming too close and I'm going to pop them, but my arms are short. I like to be here.
She likes to be here and do this drill.
Okay.
I don't like it.
Because you guys can.
That is an issue. We can put a helmet on you. Or on him.
Stay out there.
All right, I'll get out of here.
Now, it really is just that.
Okay. Okay, it's just that. Okay.
I told you. It really is just that.
The stomping has improved her timing.
Of course. You can't miss. If you're following the feet, that little plyometric is absolutely amazing.
I'm focusing on his right is going back. That's when I'm stomping.
Well, you can do it off of either foot.
I know, but I'm just able to cope with one at a time.
But don't limit.
Greg says I need to do both.
Don't limit yourself. Now, you can just do one. You can be a one-footed specialist. That's okay. He's easy to train. Because I can train him off your one foot. But if you have 2 feet, it's harder to train.
Oh, I
wasn't
calling.
Whee! Now, don't pull so much from here. Just what Eric said, flick the booger off your fingers. Just boop. That lightens up. If you hold on to something, and I'm holding on for dear life, I can't move my feet.
Right.
Okay. Well, if I'm pulling, yeah, I have to have this. But if I'm just holding, now I can move my feet. Because I can pop you and do whatever I want. And that little pop gives you a half a second to make your entry and execution. That's all you need.
Okay.
So you're looking to boop, bam. Or sometimes I'll pop a guy and then let him take the next step and take the throw.
Okay.
Which really gets fun. There you go. Now watch. Take your hand and put it flat. And now when you grab the gi, make sure that when that gi moves, see his body? Mm-hmm. Just the slightest movement. Now as we walk, it takes just that much motion. Mm-hmm. And I can go. And you own him. And it's so subtle that he never feels it. You just walk him right off the feet.
I was waiting for you to drop.
All right, your turn.
Now, take the gi. Let go. I'll take it here and here. Okay. And then when I put my hand down, my hand is flat. I'm in a pushing position.
Okay.
And I want to be in a pushing position because it takes this joint out of the element.
Okay.
Now when I move my arm, it's moving from here. Here, I have an extra joint that has to deal with. And if you're here and you're being powerful here, mm-hmm. I have three joints I can work on breaking down.
Right.
So if I can get in and break your wrist down from here, I kill your arm. Here, you're in a natural pushing position, like you're going to push a car.
Now
if I go here, your muscles automatically reflex.
Right.
And
right.
you don't have to do anything else. And I can't break this as easy as I can that.
Right.
So I always keep that hand in a pushing position.
Okay.
And pulling, it just, it's automatic.
Yeah. So you keep the left hand in a pushing position.
Yeah. I always use the seam.
Mm-hmm.
I'll grip and I'll turn.
Oh, okay.
And when you turn, see how it winds and tightens? Now, see, you're tightening on the forearm.
Mm-hmm.
I tighten right here on the elbow. And when I take my grip, now bend your arm. Takes a lot more energy. There you go.
It's tighter.
And you're using less movement and you're being more efficient. Now, what's the least amount of energy you can use and make that happen?
You kind of get 10,000 first.
There you go. Now, instead of sweeping with your foot,
mm-hmm.
I think your brain's going, got to catch him with the foot. What I want you to do is you're going to step, and I want you to sweep him with your belly button.
Okay.
When you take that step, just run through him and let your leg just kind of hang behind and see if you don't end up pushing him. You'll be moving along like that.
Yeah.
Move him with your whole center when you do that.
And this, and stomp.
Yeah. See, I pushed with my whole center. See how I arched and shot the belly through? Yeah.
Okay.
There you go. Now, don't keep both hands so rigid.
Mm-hmm.
Don't make this a bar and this a bar. Let them be ropes. Do this just with your hand and your wrist.
Okay.
Don't do it with your arm. And if this arm is tight and you're trying to pull, you're countering yourself.
Right.
And most of the time, if we're moving around and I want to pop a foot, I generally let go of the hand. Because I want that body to float way out there.
Right.
If I want the hand, and I know he's going to be this foot, I'll move my hand down here. Now you just walk right into my seoi. Time it right off of that motion.
So the stomp is just before you come up?
It's all the same. It's boom. It sets the stomp, sets the reaction for the rest of the body to come through.
Is the stomp, since it's a body drop, is it happening as his body is dropping?
Mm-hmm. See, as we're moving along, your foot touches.
Right.
Okay. My foot touches.
Okay.
And it's going to float that other foot.
Remember the first time you hit 1 out of 20? Now you're hitting like your odds are coming
down.
Yeah.
There you go. Now just push your gut through them. Woohoo! The foot sweep is the afterthought. It's the follow through. It is not the throw on that advanced foot sweep. Way, okay, just start working on making those circles. Less is more. Just your wrists. Stomp wrists. Shake your wrists. Flick the boogers. I like that analogy.
Flicking the boogers.
It's almost as good as a stripper pole. We might get into that later. And you might find, being out here, you're below the elbow. I'll always take the seam right behind the elbow. And now I've got a little bit better control.
Yeah, right here.
With less movement. There's more movement here than there is here. And then by the time I take this and turn my hand over into a pushing position, it tightens this around the elbow. And if I want to control his arm, I do this. Now bend your arm. See how it gets tight? It cuts the circulation off when you want to be strong. So now while I'm playing with this elbow.
Okay.
Hey man, you leaning on her?
Something that you did really helped her out.
Nick, make sure she gets a video of this. And she has to watch it every day for the next 2 years. When you walk this foot around, that foot is your timing.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to have your hip or the crack of your butt on his hip when that foot touches the ground.
Right.
So just, you have to take two steps to his one. It's just step, step, and that's where the throw is. Now, go in a circle.
All right.
Move in a circle and then pop it out.
Okay. You will.
There you go. Look at that. See how much momentum you get when you're moving, and all of a sudden you'll find that step in that spot and just.
Yes, sir.
So you're doing a clean. Just look at your body when you stomp your foot. Feel it. Feel your body.
I'll make sure there's.
Okay, you feel all that vibration stuff? Now put your hands up here. Now stomp flick. Now do it like that. Just stomp flick. Don't do any lift, anything. Just stomp flick at the right time. This is all pure timing.
So you don't break stride even on the speed up.
No. You're just moving. Matching steps. You'll feel when your foot touches the ground, his foot touches the ground. Stomp. That was early. Watch his feet. It's okay. I promise. Woohoo! You got it?
Yep. Greg went to trim his toenails because he kept stabbing me.
Go ahead.
Oh, me?
Yeah.
I don't even know how to move in circles. But you're way far away. I don't have the pocket grip anymore. It's totally different.
Yeah.
Okay.
Takes a little longer.
All righty. Oh, that was such a big yank. I'm sorry. I got nervous. It's different. It takes longer.
You just got to wait longer. Don't hang on to it longer. Just wait longer.
Wait longer till
just
I
flick,
do what?
Just flick the booger.
Okay.
There you go.
Oh, wait
because
longer.
if you're hanging on and trying to extend it, mm-hmm. you can't move your feet. You can't make the entry. See? You want to be able to pop and move and dance. While your body's going out, I'm watching you, and on the recovery time, I get to walk in on you. That's how I do it. Boom, there's your Ippon, or Osoto. See?
But, so I have to plant, I'm still just thinking about the timing now that we're at a much further distance because I'm holding your sleeve rather than a pocket grip. The distance is completely different, so I'm trying to figure out the timing of when I stomp and when I flick.
Don't figure it out. Feel it.
Okay.
Just do it. Just hit it. Pop it, throw it. Pop it, throw it. Move in quicker. Pop it. There you go. Look at that. And don't bend over.
Okay.
You're already executing while you're coming in. You don't have me yet. Come in and hug my arm when you come in. Much better. Now you're driving with your legs. Okay. Just spin.
What's going on there?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't realize that's where you're going with it as an entry to something like Ippon or.
Oh, everything opens. Hey, guys.
Okay.
Greg's talking over there. That's all right.